welcome back. I haven't been on for a few weeks. Life gets crazy. So I've been starting kind of this new little subcategory of my career, and that's why my schedule is more sporadic, because I'm apprenticing now as a tattoo artist. And so I'm kind of in and out now of the tattoo studio, observing and learning the process. It's gonna take about a year, so I'm hoping by next fall to be licensed, which is really exciting. So I'm kind of like back and forth between this, the tattoo studio and here, and doing mom stuff and all of that. So it's been crazy. So my work in the studio has been kind of in the evening a lot, and I haven't really been streaming as much as I would like. But I'm hoping not to stop, just gonna be a little bit more sporadic with my streaming. So this was the chimp drawing that we're working on a few weeks ago, and I really haven't worked on it too much because I wanted to finish this one while I was streaming, so that if anybody's following on YouTube, they'll actually get to see this to completion, which I think the others I kind of finished on my own and sent them on their way. But this one I really like to finish so you could see the process. So we kind of left off, and we were working on the jellyfish here in the background. So what I'd like to do today is move on to this part here and get these jellyfish in, and then put all the little finishing touches, like the dark darks and the light lights, and I'll bring out my kneaded eraser, and we'll like push things back in space and pull things out and all of that. So I'm gonna turn my music on, and then I'll start drawing. So feel free, if you have any questions, let me know. Whoa, that's loud. I should have checked the volume before I... There we go. Okay, we'll get started. See, we kind of sketched out. Let me move this a little bit. So you can see. There we go. Okay. Oh my gosh, of course my nose starts to itch as soon as I put my gloves on. Uh-oh, get a sneeze. No, I think I'm okay. Perfect. I was fine until I start streaming, and now my nose. That's how it always works. I'm just looking through. I haven't really looked at these images for a while. These are the, when we were on one of the weeks, we pulled up all these different images of jellyfish. So I was just gonna, oh my gosh, I feel like I'm gonna sneeze. Okay. There's like crazy pollen here right now. I know because my eyes always swell. It's my pollen radar. I wanted to see if I can find a picture of a jellyfish from the top. Ooh, this one's neat here. Well, we can just make it up. We've seen enough jellyfish now. So if I have a jellyfish kind of going this direction, would be the top. So this would be kind of the center, and everything would kind of go down like that. Oh my gosh, caught out of the corner of my eye the tiniest little spider. Can you see it? If I put it, it's crawling up. There it is, like I caught his little string. I'm gonna go put him outside real quick. Come on, little guy, let's go. Let's go. It's okay, Ozzy, it's okay. Okay, I put him outside. Ozzy was like, are we going? Are we going? Oh, I just dumped this. Oh, it's another one. Huh. Must have been some little spiders that hatched. Where did this go? We dropped it. Okay, got it. How did all these bugs get in here? I just got bit by a mosquito. Hi, mocap. Good to see you. There's a mosquito in here, and it just got my leg. No, I didn't. I was going to, but I ended up having some other work that needed to be completed, and I really wanted to finish this one online, so on YouTube you could actually watch the progression. So I kind of put it aside and just brought it out again today. My schedule is going to be very different this next year, so I'm getting used to kind of being in the studio, out of the studio, and but the good news is, now once I upload this to YouTube, that you can actually see the progression. But I did do some other work. I could bring it out and show you. So I've been working on this series. Let's see, where are they? I'll show you one of the series because I kind of want some of them to be a surprise, but I'm working on this owl series. This little guy. So I'm doing a series of different types of owls. So I've been working on that. And I might live stream one of those. So we'll see. Right now I'm just kind of having to take a deep breath and just see what happens with my schedule and streaming and all of that. Things are super busy. Daughter's back in school. There's activities. It's to take a deep breath because sometimes when I say it all out loud, I get a little overwhelmed. But I'm grateful for the time today to be able to stream and show this progress and kind of enjoy this. Sharpen this. I don't know what. Did you? Is there all these like alerts coming up? I'm not sure what's going on. Oh, gives my viewers. Oh, that's so cool. That sounds some like wizarding magic that you did, but. Okay. Thank you. That's really cool. This computer language thing is not necessarily something I'm fluent in, and anybody that's watched these probably knows that. But thank you. I always appreciate that kind of help. It's a bit intimidating. My brain doesn't work that way. And I'm just excited that I figured out how to turn all this stuff on in my studio. I'm just kind of like popping away the face now, or the top of the head from this jellyfish kind of in the background here. jellyfish right here. Any gallery shows? Yes. So for 2020, I just got back from Wyoming last week, and I had a show at Museum of Animal Art in Jackson Hole. So that's up, I think, until October. Gosh, I don't think I announced that. So if anybody's in Jackson Hole or near Jackson Hole at the Museum of Animal Art there, I have two pieces up, and then, let's see, this winter I'll have a museum show, but I can't really discuss it yet until the contracts are all signed, and that's on the East Coast, and then it looks like summer and fall of 2020 is going to be my show season, my big, so I'll have a solo exhibition in Denver, September 2020. And several group shows, but all kind of in Montana, Wyoming, Colorado, that kind of triangle up there. That's so far what's in the books. There might be a few little group shows here and there where I'll just have one or two pieces in, kind of in between, but that's what I have written down on my calendar so far for 2020. So 2020 is gonna be in some of my favorite places, like Colorado, Montana, Wyoming. I'll be in Wyoming in September as well, so I'll kind of be traveling and be staying out there for some different events in September. Yeah, the festival in Laguna, it's supposed to be really nice. Laguna's beautiful. Oh, an artist room has a booth there? That's cool. Oh, thank you, Kiki Cat. I'm almost got, I think maybe I'll put one more here and then just clean this up and we're pretty much there with this drawing. Oh, how do I know? It's weird because I always think I can add just a little bit more. And I do generally think it's done and then I'll fiddle with it before it goes to a show or back to whoever purchased it. Gosh, it's actually a really hard question because I never feel like things are really done. I've just learned to stop, just let it go. But this one, I had a really clear idea for kind of what I wanted the whole time. And you don't want too much more going on in here. I don't want to add any more animals, and it's rare for me to say that, but that's not the feeling I want from this. I want this kind of feeling that they're just like surrounded by these jellyfish and there's a lot of movement, and so that's kind of what I'm just gonna be working on for this. I think I'm just gonna clean it up and make it really sharp and that's it, not add just to add things. I wanna add because it has meaning or there's like a symbol to it or there's a reason, but I'm not feeling that with this drawing, so I'm not gonna do that. I'm just gonna trust my instinct and finish rendering these jellyfish and go back in and then push the lights and darks and then that's it. Thank you. Oh, this caught my eye as three butterflies just flew past. I can see them go in front of this window here. Okay, I'll be right back. I am again super hydrated and I have to run. I'll be right back. Sorry for leaving. Azzy, you stay here. Keep everybody company. Stay, I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. I have a decision to make. I can push this one back and kind of overlap. No, I don't need to do that. Let's see. right here. You can make the white part come up, kind of go over. Let's sketch it out and see. Kind of like this squiggly part of this one overlapping this one. I was gonna put one there, but I don't have one on that side. Maybe. Let's see what it looks like on the screen. Maybe if I'm one coming like this. Yeah, that's what I like that better. The 4B here. I'm gonna push some contrast now. Switch 6B right here. See these dark darks now popping out? Oops, sorry. Did like the nostrils, the pupils. Okay, I got the knead eraser out. I pull out some bright. Okay, I think we're pretty much there. So this is the completed chimp with jellyfish. And there we go. So thank you everybody for joining, and thank you MoCap for your help. And hopefully I'll be back soon to live stream another drawing. So everybody have a fantastic rest of your day, and thanks for watching.